Today we are going to start class 8 history chapter number 6 traders to rulers British conquest of India. So in this chapter we are going to study in a detailed manner that how these Britishers who came as a traders and they became the rulers of our country. So let us begin. After the fall of Constantinople in 1453, the old trading routes between East and the West came under the Turkish control. Now the Europeans, they wanted to open a direct trade relation with the East, and the first steps were taken by whom? It was taken by the Portugal and Spain. Now in 1498, Vasco da Gama, he discovered a new route and reached to Calicut. Now in 1600, the English East India Company, they were successful in opening the first factory at Surat. And in 1613, the Emperor Jahangir, he issued a firman permitting the English to establish their factory at Surat. So this helped the English to start trading in India. Now in 1717, Farrukh Siyar granted the company to carry on duty-free trade in Bengal, Bihar and Odisha, and it acted as a boon to them, a profitable investment for them and the best opportunity to earn wealth. And now the French East India Company, they had established their factory, and they also have the factories in Pondicherry, then Mahe, then Chander Nagore. So these are the places where they had established the factories, means expanded their trade. Now let us talk about the Carnatic Wars. Now the Carnatic was one of the Shubha of Deccan under control of Nizam of Hyderabad. This Carnatic was under the control of whom? Nizam of Hyderabad. Now the Nawab of Carnatic, he defined the authority of the Nizam and he established his own empire. Now this led to wars between these two and the English, and French took advantage of it. Now during the 18th century, the French emerged as a serious threat to the growing powers of the East India Company in India. Then the rivalry between the two, they affected the rivalry between the two. Two are which groups? That is the French and East India Company. The rivalry between the two affected the settlement in India and outside Europe. Now their rivalry, it led to three other Carnatic Wars between the year 1740 to 1763. So this is how and when the Carnatic War started and in which situation it started. Now moving on to the rise of the British power in Bengal. In Bengal, how did the British, they rose their power, established their power? Now the Nawab of Bengal, he was always followed a policy of keeping the European traders under control. Now Siraj ud-Daulah, the Nawab of Bengal, found himself in dispute with the English. Now the main cause of the dispute with them was the additional fortification of Calcutta, that is when it extended the Kolkata, which the English and recently undertaken ostensibly as a measure of precaution against the French. But Siraj ud-Daulah, he disapproved this. However, the British refused and it started imposing taxes on them. Now let us discuss about the three Carnatic War. So the first Carnatic War, it took place between 1744 to 1748. Now within whom this battle was fought? It was fought between Anwar Uddin and Nawab of Arcot and the French. So between these it was fought. Now the allies, who were the allies? That is the British, it supported the Nawab of Arcot. So the Britishers, they were with the Nawab of Arcot. Now who was victorious in this particular Carnatic War? The French. The French defeated the Nawab of Arcot. That means that the French defeated also the Britishers, because the Britishers were supporting the Nawab of Arcot. And
what was the outcome? At last, they had to end up by signing the Treaty of Exala Chapel was signed and was brought to an end. So this was the outcome of the Carnatic War. Now, if you go through this particular paragraph that is given, you will understand it in detail. Now, moving on to the Second Carnatic War. The Second Carnatic War was of succession in Hyderabad after the rulers of Carnatic and Hyderabad, they die in 1748. Now, in this war, who were the allies? That is, in Arcot, Chanda Sahib was supported by the French. So, this Arcot, the Chanda Sahib was supported by the French. Now, the English defeated the French in this particular war. In the First Carnatic War, the French defeated the Nawab of Arcot. But in the Second Carnatic War, the English were successful in defeating the French. Now, a Treaty of Pondicherry was signed and British, they established their control over Carnatic. Now, in the Third Battle of Carnatic, what happened? An extension of another European war, the 7 Years' War, which broke out in 1756 between England and France. So, this Third Carnatic War, it was extended till 7 years, and it was held between whom? Between England and France. Now, French army was defeated by the British in this particular at the Battle of Wandiwash in 1760, and again a Treaty of Paris was signed in 1763, and Pondicherry was returned to the French. However, they were not permitted to fortify it. So this is the Third Carnatic War. So to understand in a better way, you have to read the chapter thoroughly. That is the that is in page number 47 and 48. Now, moving on to the Battle of Plassey, on June 23, 1757, again a battle was fought, that was fought between English and the Siraj-ud-Daulah. Now, the Siraj-ud-Daulah, he was defeated by the Nawab and was killed. Now, this battle paved the way to whom? To the British in Bengal now. Now, the plentiful revenues of Bengal enabled the English to maintain the army. So, they got enough huge amount of revenues from Bengal, which helped the English to maintain its army and strengthen its army. Now, Mir Zafar was made a puppet Nawab. He was made the puppet Nawab by whom? He was made by the Britishers, a puppet Nawab who used to act or work according to the demands of the Britishers. And moreover, the English were given the right of free trade in Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. So they were not, did not have to pay any kind of taxes. So their earning was very good. If we talk about the result of the Battle of Plassey, it helped the English to lay down the foundation of their empire and completely root out both the Nawab and the French from the country. Now, the English got the right of free trade in Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. That means it helped them to increase their income. Now, they even got the territory of 24 Parganas with them. And Mir Zafar was made a puppet Nawab of Bengal, and he gave a large amount of money to Clive and other officials as reward. The royal treasury was almost empty because everything the puppet Nawab was rewarding to Clive. And the Nawab did not have enough money to pay his army. He began to turn against the company, but the helpless Nawab had no choice but to abdicate rather than to yield to the demands of the English. So his treasury was empty, and he could no more fulfill the demands of the English. So this is the result of the Battle of Plassey. Now, moving on to the Battle of Buxar, it took place in 1764. Now, Mir Qasim, that son-in-law of Mir Zafar, was made the next Nawab. Mir Qasim, he wanted to free himself from the English. So, he shifted his capital from Calcutta to Munger. Now, he took the help of Europeans to train his soldiers, and he also abolished Farman. Now, this activity of his that led to a war between the English and Mir Qasim. Now, the Nawab in the war, he was defeated and he was driven out of Bengal. Now, he fled to Patna, and there he killed the English prisoners and officials, and then he went to Awadh. Now when he went to Awadh, there he formed a confederacy with Nawab Sujaud-Daula. Now this confederacy army was again defeated. It was not the confederacy did not succeeded. They had to face the defeat by the English in the Battle of Buxar. Now what was the outcome of it? What was the outcome of the Battle of Buxar? Now it increased the prestige and the power of the Britisher. Now the Britisher have proved themselves to be the most powerful and actually led the foundation of British Empire in India. Now in the English defeated the three important powers and they became the masters of Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. Now the Diwan granted by the Mughals emperor greatly increased the income of the company. Now they had become financially also very much stable and financially they have proved themselves to be very strong. Now it proved the military, this war also proved the military strength of the British, for it was won not by treachery but by military superiority and strategy. And Robert Clive became the governor of the English company and he introduced dual government in 1765. So this is how the Britishers, they from the traders, they became the rulers of the country. So to understand it better, you have to go through the chapters.